lecture, we are going to see what it means to take decisions in uncertain situations. As a recap, uncertainty means that the decision maker is aware about the main variables to consider into the decision-making process, as well as the main scenarios, but is not able to assign a probability of occurrence to each scenario. This is the typical situation where managers do not rely on historical data or they do not think their perception of the reality is reliable and accurate. In this case, the main features of the problems are similar to situations in a risk environment because the decision maker should manage multiple objectives with the goal to maximize the expected value through a minimization of the uncertainty. On the other hand, usable criteria are different because probability of occurrence are not available. But could decision maker take decisions under uncertain conditions? There are five main criteria to take decision, and to see how this works, we are going to use a numerical example. Let's start with the first criterion. The first criterion is called Pascal criterion and aims at considering all the scenarios as likely on equal terms. Said with other words, this criterion is managing a problem in a certain environment, such as one in risky environment, giving some estimated probability to each scenario. In this case, in our example, we are giving a probability of 33% to each scenario, and so we are now able to compute both the expected value and the standard deviation, which are respectively 15 and 16.3 for decision 1 and 20 and 24.5 per decision 2. Now, the decision maker can use the same criteria we saw in class about risk. The second criterion is called Maximax. This is the typical approach used by optimistic people because it aims at selecting the best payoff for each alternative independently to which scenario is going to happen, and then the best of the best is taken as decision. The basic assumption of this method is that for sure the best scenario is going to happen. In our example, for D1, the best option is 35. For D2, the best option is 50. Between 35 and 50, the maximum is 50, and so the decision maker prefers D2. Actually, this criterion is neglecting uncertainty without taking into consideration that this scenario might also not happen at all. The third criterion is called Maximin or Wald criterion. On the contrary to previous one, this is the typical approach adopted by pessimistic people because it aims at selecting the payoff related to the worst scenario for each alternative, and then the best of the worst option is taken as decision. The basic assumption of this method is actually that for sure the worst scenario is going to happen. On the other hand, the decision maker is pessimistic but not self-defeating, and so the maximum is selected. In our example, for D1 the worst option is -5, whereas for D2 is -10. In this case, the decision maker prefers D1. Contrary to previous one, this criterion is taking into consideration the uncertainty using the prudence principle. On the other hand, this method is missing the potential value obtainable if the best scenario is becoming true. The fourth criterion is called the realism criterion or Hurwitz criterion, which aims at blending the main features of the last two. Thereby, a value is associated to each decision, combining the results achievable when the best and the worst scenarios are going to happen. The combination of the two results is weighted by an alpha coefficient, called optimistic coefficient, from 0 to 1, depending whether the decision maker is more optimistic or pessimistic. If, for example, we select an alpha equal to 0.3, we obtain a result equal to 7 for D1 and equal to 8 for D2. In spite of the stronger relevance to the negative result, D2 is appearing the best solution for this method. because the delta between positive result, 35 and 50, is much higher than the delta between negative results, minus 5 and minus 10. The pros of this method is the possible combination of positive and negative results. The cons of this method relies on the subjective definition of the value of alpha. Finally, as in the case of risk, we could also look for the solution of a dilemma through the method of the missed opportunity. As a recap, the missed opportunity is the value lost in case one scenario is going to happen, but the decision maker took the wrong decision. The criterion used with this new payoff table is called minimax or regret criterion. As the maximin, this is mainly a pessimistic criterion, or differently said, a prudent criterion. Indeed, the decision through this method is the one that allows to minimize the loss in case the worst scenario is happening. In our example, for D1, the worst option is 15, whereas for D2 is 5. In this case, the decision maker prefers D2.